Businesses here.
This main room here, you would have had chairs on this side, on that side, that would have been a table six.
This bar opened 2 years ago. It had a great start to the week thanks to the Eat Out to Help Out initiative. Now, more worries about bottom trade.
We were quite busy this weekend. We've had probably about like 9 tables cancelled for today. Normally on a Saturday we'd be quite busy around this time, maybe people are 60 people in dining.
Authorities here that asked for tighter rules to be brought in with a direct message to the under 30s.
Well, don't kill Granny really means don't pick up the virus and don't take his phone. So for young people who may think they'll get mild if any symptoms or be asymptomatic, the problem we've got is if they pick it up, they take it home.
The stricter measures in affected areas will be reviewed next week. Philip Norton, BBC News.
Let us think. 58 new confirmed cases of COVID-19 across the UK in the latest 24-hour period, with the average number of infections each day in the last week being 832. There were 55 deaths recorded, taking the overall total in the UK to 46,566. On average, in the past week, there were 53 deaths every day. Three quarters of a million coronavirus testing kits used in care homes have been recalled by regulators. The government said last month their swabs were not up to standard, but the test results from the kits provided by the healthcare group Randox are not effective. Tougher rules on the wearing of face coverings also took effect today. If you're in England and Scotland, you now have to wear them in museums and cinemas, as Katie Austin explains.
The big screen is back. 10 of cinema chain View's 90 sites reopened yesterday, including this one in London's Shepherd's Bush, after more than 4 months closed.
So are you a little bit excited?
Too excited to say a little bit.
And what are you going to see?
I'm going to see Dreamfield.
Things are different, including one-way systems and...